Wait, check this out. Ready? Ready? Boing. Oh, that's great. That's so great. What's up, people? I'm Zog, and welcome back to ARK Survival Evolved. Oh, it doesn't see the Bronto as a landing space. That would have been so cool! Land on a Bronto? Are you kidding me? That would have been amazing! Ah, just so curious. Can I do this? I'm so curious. We'll get on to things here in a minute. Hold on, peeps. I'm trying to land on a Bronto. No, stop. Stop moving. Actually, you can keep moving. You move so slow, it's fine. No, up. So difficult to maneuver. Pterodon. Pteranodon, I mean. Land! Nope, you're not gonna do it. Anyway, so I've been working, I'm just trying to land on a Bronto, peeps. It's fine. I was working out a little bit of a design for our little cage things. I think they need to be longer to accommodate the longer dinos, like the mammoth and that, and pretty much everything except the trikes and the smaller ones. The smaller ones will probably be fine, but we want them all kind of uniformish. And, I think this turned out okay. Like, it's not great. It's not fantastic. I actually had a different design in mind, but it wouldn't work because pillars, and now just imagine this. Now, instead of this other slope that's here, hold on, let me try, see if I can explain it to you, just so you have the idea in your head, since I can't actually do it. Take this little piece off, right? So then it comes straight down, and then put a pillar, a wooden pillar, right on the end of it. Right? That's what I tried to do. I couldn't get that done because I think it would have been sticking up just a little bit higher and then it would have given it like a little more of a shape thing there, but I don't know. I think it would have looked pretty cool, but now it's just kind of one straight slope. It's like, meh. But I couldn't place the pillar there. I even tried to remove everything. I built this thing like two or three times because I kept destroying stuff and what does they call it? Demolishing things. That's what they call it. I tried to place the pillar first. Oh, there's a big shadow. Oh, hi, Bronto. You scared the crap out of me. You know that, man? Payback, huh? Payback. For trying to land on you? Yeah, I know it. I know it, you little punk. So anyway, but I tried to put this pillar here, and it just, I don't know. I tried to put the pillar down first, tried to put this down first, and then this, and then this, and yeah, it just doesn't work. It just doesn't work, and you just poke, man. What are you doing? All right, get me out of here. Bronto's going to step on me. He doesn't like me very much. But what I have over here is actually a whole bunch of cooking. I'm getting a whole bunch of meat. Now, why am I getting meat? That's a pretty good question. That's a very good question. We're going on a little bit of a trip, all right? But we do have quite a bit of meat. Like, we have a lot of it. We have a lot of meat, okay? Now, the reason that we have so much meat is actually because we're going to try to tame some ichthys. Now, let me explain why I'm getting cooked meat, because some of you, if in fact ichthys do eat raw meat, right? If they eat raw meat, then some of you are going to be like, why the heck are you cooking it? Because I don't know that they eat raw meat. I don't know that. The first time I have ever encountered the ichthys, actually, that was fine. The first time I ever encountered ichthys, I did already have the cooked meat on my bar. At the end slot. And I had no idea about, you know, the last slot stuff or anything like that. And now I do. Now I know about that, all that good stuff. But it said push E to feed it cooked meat. Now, it probably told me to go ahead and feed it cooked meat just because that is what I had at the end of my bar. But I think raw meat might work better. I'm not sure. I'm going to do a little bit of research in here in between cuts just to see what happens. The wiki says, I believe it says that raw meat actually works better than cooked meat. But I could be wrong. I could be wrong. So I'm going to look it up. We're going to see what happens. I'm going to bring both just in case that cooked meat is actually what they want to eat more so than raw meat. But in this case, I do have a bunch of this stuff as well. So we're going to drop all this on this guy. We're going to wait for these other two to finish up here. I'm going to collect everything that I need, and we're going to go get ourselves some ichthys, in case that wasn't obvious. You ready to go hunt some ichthys? No, you can't bite them. No, Snow, I know you want to bite everything. You can't bite the ichthys. All right. Good. Good boy. There's your howl. All right. right, so here's the Nycthia. It appears to be trapped, and it's only level 4. All right, so that does kind of bother me a little bit, but the wiki says that, and again, it's the wiki, so, you know, but it says that one aquatic creature can attract others. So that's what I'm kind of looking for. They kind of attract. They you know, flock to each other, basically. So if I have a level 4, it doesn't matter what level this guy is, I can bring the higher level ones to me as well. So let's see when this guy gets hungry again. You have to wait until he gets hungry again. There's a turtle. Last time it was the turtles that that ate him. So yeah, okay. They don't actually do that. Feed raw meat. Oh yeah, raw meat's definitely the way to go. Alright, cool. So I just have a whole bunch of cooked meat ready to go. It's all probably going to spoil before I even come close to using it. But you know what? That's okay. That's alright. I'm okay with that. I can deal. Oh, wow. You're already ready. Oh, well. Ready. You know, so cooked meat is actually far worse because not only does it give less of a taming bar, it actually keeps them fed for longer. They don't get hungry as fast if you use cooked meat, which is kind of interesting. It's kind of a neat little thing. Anyway, I did actually go ahead. See, he's ready already. Bam. Oh, we're almost done. We're almost done with him. And I did go ahead and bring the Ichthyosaurus saddle. So that's pretty cool. This guy isn't following. We just got to keep track of him. We're going to be using him a little bit. See if we can draw some higher ones around. And then that's what we're going to do. And we're going to see if how high of an Ichthy we can actually get and bring back to our base. Come on, man. There we go. Bam! Got an Ichthyosaurus. Done deal. All right. Nope. Don't do that. I don't know. I'm not going to name you anything just yet, buddy. All right, saddle. Let's do this. How fast are you? Not very? Well, you're stuck, man. Ha! Well, that's pointless. We can't, like, pick you up. Are you going to die? Well, you're not dying, but you are stuck. Interesting. Can't, like, push you or anything. Can we punch him? Didn't take too much damage from that. Can we can't, like, punch you out of glitch? Out of glitch mode? No. Can't jump. Can't move. We can't move him at all. Blech. Look at that, man. Can we go in any direction to, like, move at all? We can't. We totally can't. So we have a pointless Ichthy. But at least we know that raw meat is the way to go. So test complete. I just want to go free. Alright, here's another one. Again, he's only level 3, but you know what? That is fine, because that means he's going to tame up pretty quick, and we'll be able to play with him. We'll be able to swim around and see what happens. But he's not going to take that long, but still, you don't want to sit here and wait for him to get hungry 4 times. So, I'll skip right to the end. You know, I really, really like these guys. They just kind of come to you when it's time to eat. Like, yummy. Yummy meat. You're so smart. You're so smart, dolphin thing. You come right back to me every time it's time to eat. I gotta make sure I get air so I don't suffocate or drown. I mean, that's not suffocating, that's drowning. There is a difference. There's a difference, you know. Are you coming back? Is it time to eat? No, not yet? Okay. We're gonna see if this works again. So far, he's pretty much come to me every time when it's time to eat. Is it time to eat, buddy? All right. No problem. Bam. It's done. You see that? It's so amazing. All right. Come here. Let's go. Let's play with you. What? What should you? Oh, look. There's another one. Look at that. What level are you? Other guy. Oh, look. A level 10. Let's tame this guy too. We can do this. No problem. Now we already have one tamed. We don't want you. Oh, wow. Oh, super fast. Oh, super fast. It's amazing. Yeah, see, they flock together. See, I'm drawing him in now. Now I have a level 10 that's taming up. All I gotta do is kind of station this guy right here in the water. And the other one's just gonna, like, follow him around. How cool is that? That's so amazing. You ready to eat yet? No, not yet? Alright, cool. Anyway, so I'm just gonna go ahead and kind of... I dub this... Stay put, buddy. Stay put, I said. I don't want you trapped. There we go. I dub this named Tame Chain. This is a tame chain. I'm gonna keep tame chaining this to get a whole bunch of ichthys, I guess. I don't know. Anyway, I gotta answer her. So, yeah, give me a second. I had no idea these things had names and levels. You're a level 62 coal or coel? What are you called, thing? Oh, that's so cool. Alright, so now we have a level 14 and a level 4. So let's compare some stats, shall we? We have health, 275, stamina, 300, 925, food, that doesn't matter. Weight, blah, 255, sure. 277 melee damage and 100% movement speed. So this is pretty close to basic, stats here. So let's see. Oh, I'm drowning. Yeah, it's one of those things. All right, let's check you out, man. 289, a little bit more health. 480 stamina. 255 weight, still that. Damage 304, 100 movement. What did you have? Stamina was 300, so he's got more stamina, and he's got a little bit more melee damage. That's pretty much the biggest difference. Movement speed didn't really change all that much, but these guys already move really, really, really fast in the water. So that's kind of a thing that happens. Let's go ahead and change the saddle over. We're going to see if we can't get some more ichthys. And once I get a pretty good one that I'm comfortable with bringing back to base, I'll bring back to show you. So fast. I don't know why an ichthy's making not so sounding like a car sound. Okay. I'm done with that. No worries. I'm done with that. Okay, this is cool. This is really cool. Look. The guy's like just following me. Sorry about that little lag glitch thing. Look, he just follows me. I can do what I want. I can just lead him right to my taming area, which isn't my taming area, by the way. Somebody's already building over here. And if that's you, I'm sorry. I am borrowing your taming location. Because it's amazing. This is a really cool spot, actually. Come on, buddy. You still following me? Yeah, you sure are, man. All right, let's go tame this guy up. I don't even know what level you are. But for some reason, I want you anyway. Oh, look. Now he likes the other guy. What level are you, guy? Are you good? Oh, 31. Oh, that's cool. Totally, man. Don't swim away. Stay around here. Yeah, you're going to be my friend. What? Megalodon? Are you kidding me? Dude, this is so cool, man. Why are you at 67 already? What happened? You didn't get hit. Oh, you might have gotten hit after you were unconscious by Ichthy over there. Anyway, so what the heck happened? So I was out on this guy looking for more Ichthys. I was looking for a higher level one for whatever reason. 45 is pretty good. I'm comfortable with 45. I'm okay with 45. But 45 doesn't bother me. But, I did find another one. I have no idea what level he was, but this Megalodon was trying to chomp on him. Apparently, I got too close because he switched targets to me. And, yeah, then I was like, you know what? I'm so quick. I can lap him like no nothing else. This guy's pretty slow in the water. And this guy's super speedy. So I had no trouble just kind of kiting him around all the way into the shallow water. Now, that wasn't the smartest idea, I guess, because the other two Ichthys, they died by this guy. He ate both of them. So that's kind of a thing that happened. But it's not too big of a deal. It's really not too big of a deal. But now we have a knocked out Megalodon that we are taming up with raw meat and stuff. And we have a level 45 Ichthy. This guy is apparently only going to be level 26. We'll eventually get a better one. No worries on that. But I didn't have a Megalodon. I was like, you know what? Why not? Why not? You know, seriously, why wouldn't I try to tame this guy? So that's what we're doing now. I'm just going to stick around, hang out for a little bit. This is a very, very nice area. So whoever is set up over there, thank you for the use of your location. And yeah, this place is amazing. Very, very good pick, man. Very good pick. This is good. This is really good. It's not too far away from mine, actually. You keep going around off in that direction, like just follow the mountain around. and you'll run into mine pretty easily. But yeah, it's a pretty cool thing. Eat your meat, man. Oh, you did eat. You ate one more. Only one though. Hurry up. Hurry up, Megalodon. We're gonna go back to my base. I have a couple sea creatures now, which is really cool. Wait, check this out. Ready? Boing! Oh, that's great. That's so great. Alright, well, this guy should be taming up here any second. He got about 3 hunger points, I'm thinking. He might be done. He might need one more. I'm not sure. Are you gonna be done here? Oh, we got a Megalodon! Look at that. You have tamed a Megalodon. All right, perfect. So, we're not going to name him yet, but we are going to make sure he follows me. And now I have to try to get tricky with this because we have one land guy and one ground guy that both need to follow me. So if I do something like this, will they? Okay, he does for sure. The Megalodon does not. If I go out here, will you? Can you not follow me? I don't know. All right, let me go get my Ichthy and we'll see if we can get this guy moving. All right, so now we're going to do a real quick change of pace, really. Really quick, not too much. But you see, we're over here at Lilac's place and she had to run off real quick. Some unavoidable thing just kind of happened. Sporadic moment, all that good stuff. It happens, but she's got this wild Paraceratherium. Such a fun word to say. Such a fun name. I love that. Paraceratherium. Actually, I have a theory, by the way, other than the fact that they're dinos. Right? And dinos always have, like, really long, hard-to-pronounce names, right? Well, not always, but you know what I mean. They're always longer names, like Asaurs and everything. But I have a theory about these names. Paraceratherium, I think... they do want to avoid people just keeping the default name. They want people to personalize their dinos. So they make the names a little bit harder. They're really fun to say, Paraceratherium. Your name is really fun to say. But they want people to rename them. They want me to call you Phoenix and not Pteranodon. That's what I think. That's my theory. Anyway, moving on. So we have the Paraceratherium right here. And we're just kind of keeping an eye on it, making sure everything goes well. We'll just go ahead and use a few more of these. Eating up plenty of berries. It's going to be okay. Now, it did get attacked. There was a Titan bow that kind of came over and attacked it a little bit. But its health is okay. But the taming effectiveness did go down to 60%. But overall, that's not a huge deal. Level 9, it probably only lost like one level, two levels maybe. So it's not a huge problem. And then you have a Lilac. I am sorry. There's a story surrounding this guy. Now, a little while ago, before the swamp was there, there was that big old lake and everything. And Lilac was... lag thing. There's a big old, lake thing over there. Kind of like an oasis deal. And Lilac was over there doing whatever she was doing at the time. And this Carno came over and killed her, the raptor we helped her tame, and the Packy we helped her tame, and her flyer. Like, he killed everything. The Carno just demolished everything. It was rough. It was really, really rough time for her. So, she was all a little bummed out about it. So I tried to make her feel better by taming the Carno that killed her. You killed her, you stupid Carno. You took her dinos away from her, you dumb Carno. So I tamed him up. So now the Carno that killed her and her three dinos is now her guardian. So I tamed him up and I gave him to her. So now she has a pretty good guardian here. Now he's on this side because he's going to be able to take pretty much anything that comes up. And then we have the rest of her dinos on this side. So if anything comes over in this side, hopefully it will attack. Actually, let's walk you over here. So that way, if anything does come in the area, it will attack one of our actual tribe's dinos, and everything in the area will just kind of, you know, be... well, all of these dinos will swarm it and demolish it before, hopefully, before it can ever get to the Paraceratherium. Now, that's just kind of the thing that's happening. I wanted to run you down with that real quick. The other thing I wanted to do, come here, you. Look at her water source. She has water in her base. It's right there feeding those plots. But look at this thing. She brought pipe all the way from the ocean. How cool is that? Now, some of you are saying there's probably easier ways to do it, but we don't know everything and everything about the game. So if you know one, go ahead and leave a suggestion. I can pass it on to her, and it'd be pretty cool. I know there are the water reservoirs, which do work mostly. Actually, let me refill my water now that it's raining. You know, that I guess they fill up with rain and stuff like that, and, you know, that's pretty cool. They last a little while and stuff like that, but I don't know how long they last. I don't know how good they are or anything like that, so it's kind of a meh situation. Now, at the very least, she'll never run out of water, like, ever. She's not going to drain the ocean. That's not a thing that can happen. Anyway, so I just wanted to... get out of the wall. There we go. Can you land? There. Thank you. So anyway, we're just going to keep our eye on this guy, this Paraceratherium. And once this guy's done, I'm going to be back at base. But I figured it was pretty good. Be a good opportunity to go ahead and just kind of bring you along. All right, it's already Gamma 2. It looks really, really, really bright. But I just kind of figured I would bring you along and show you what Lilac's been up to. The recent little bits. Hello, Megalodon. You know, I never pronounce the A in that word, or name, or species name, ever. Like, I always say Megalodon. I never actually said Megalodon. It's a Megalodon. It's a Megalodon. So anyway, we did get our Megalodon over here. We also got our Ichthy over here, and these guys are really, really close, and I really don't like it, so I wish I had some kind of a pen for this guy. But really, if he dies... If I can get the saddle again, it wouldn't be a huge deal. I'm not sure if I have the blueprint for the saddle, for that saddle, or the scorpion saddle. I think it might be the scorpion saddle. But either way, we can learn it. We do have the Ingram points, and we do have it, you know, the ability to learn that saddle. It's not too incredibly much. So we can do that if we have to. But there's a couple other things I haven't actually mentioned here. And one of which is that these little rocks right here are all oil. Like, these are, maybe not that one. But I know that one is, that one is, that one is. I just mined one from there. That one is. Yeah, all these rocks, they're all oil. And also, if you look carefully down there at the bottom of the water, you see what that is, right? Some of you will know. Those are silica pearls. And you get about 10 from each, roughly speaking. 10 from each. Now, I haven't collected a huge amount because I don't have a whole lot of things that require them, but they are there when we need them, and hopefully that doesn't change anytime soon, but it might. And if it does, you know what? Oh, well, we just have to dive to the bottom of the ocean, be a little bit more of a pain in the butt. I don't want to collect a huge amount of those right now. I don't want to do that because resource gathering is a pain in the butt, and I don't like to do it. So, yeah, that's the thing. Now, let me show you this other stuff first. Check this stuff out. First of all, let's go up here. We have to get set up. We gotta set ourselves up. You do see my chest piece, right? Yeah, it's pretty amazing. You see my gloves, right? Oh, you see me poop, right? Yeah. Pooping's not important. But what is important, ramshackle chitin gauntlets. What now? That's amazing. Oh, yeah, regular chitin, but still chitin, which means it's better. That's amazing. Ramshackle metal, we have one. We found one pick. You see the stats on this? Max durability 64.2, weapon damage 124. This one is 54.6 and 127. So this one's actually a little bit better. It's going to harvest things more, but it's going to die faster, basically. But we do have the blueprint for that, so we can make a bunch of these if we need to. That's absolutely amazing, and I love it. We also have the blueprint for a ramshackle chitin helmet, which we haven't made yet, but we totally can. All right, so what we're going to start doing, we're going to bring this guy out, because this is a smithy thing. This is a smithy thing. We also got a few more blueprints and stuff. I've been flying around a little while, kind of looking at some stuff, getting some supply drops. We got a bunch of compasses. We got two smithies, two forges, whole bunch of water bottles. Everybody's got extras to those. I have a blueprint for Pulmonoscorpius and Ichthyosaurus saddle. So I have both of those. That's amazing. And, you know, we've just, I don't know, we got a bunch of stuff. We're going to go ahead and put these blueprints in here because, honestly, we don't need them to be anywhere else. We're just going to go ahead and put those right up here just so we have them ready. Anytime we're ready to make them. What do we need for you, actually? Let's go ahead and make the helmet. We need a bunch more chitin is what we need. Do we have, one piece here. I know we have a whole bunch of chitin somewhere. I know you don't have any on you. You don't either. I just emptied, you might. Thought I emptied you out. Yeah. We got another metal pick here and another blueprint. Chitin. Do you have chitin on you, Stompy? You have 7 chitin. That's better than nothing. What about you, Bladeback? You got some chitin? Oh, yeah. Totally. Totally. All the chitin. Not all of it. Most of it, though. We got a whole bunch of chitin. Let's go ahead and grab some more hide as well. We're just going to throw a few extra things in there. Oh, yeah. See? Lots and lots of chitin. Look at that. That's marvelous. Another piece of metal. We're going to go ahead and throw this stuff in there for repairing our fur stuff. Some keratin. Why not? And, yeah, we'll keep that there for now. Anyway. So I'm just going to make up this stuff real quick. And we're going to go get a T-Rex. I don't know if I mentioned that yet. I really want a T-Rex. I don't know why. I can't ride one, so I can't really use one all that much. Oh, look, another supply drop. Are you already at the ground? Does not appear that you're already at the ground. Could be wrong. Nope, not yet. Where are you, thing? You're way there. All right, you're coming down. You'll be down soon. Anyway, so we're going to go ahead, and we're just going to make this stuff that I was just mentioning, this guy right here, craft you. I can make 5 of them, apparently, but I don't need 5. Let's go ahead and put a whole bunch of this stuff in this system. We're going to go ahead. Ooh, nope. But, yeah, we're going to do this, and then I'm going to be right back after I find some kind of a Rex or something that is worth anything. Let's go ahead and eat another prime cooked meat. Yum, yum. All right, peeps, check it out. Let's fly a little bit to the side and look over here. This is the Rex that I want. I am going big or I am going home because Wild Male Rex level 62, guess what? He is a lot higher. He at least 5 times higher than any other Rex I've found. Maybe not quite 5, but pretty daggone close. I have no idea if we can find somewhere to get this guy in order to, you know, get him like I want to. We need to find a place to stand, aggro him, bring him over, and actually shoot him until he passes out, and then we can feed him. He did not just die, did he? No, he didn't. Okay, no, he's a beast! Oh my goodness. So, anyway, I don't have a huge amount of time left in this episode, but I definitely wanted to bring you along for this, so I gotta make it quick. I'm gonna go find some stuff, I'm gonna figure some things out, and we're gonna see if we can't get this Rex. Best news is you see where I am, it's actually pretty close to my base, so that's gonna be another benefit to this guy being right here. It's amazing. Alright, peeps, let's see if we can get him. I gotta wait a little while in between arrows. I don't have a full stack of 100 or anything. My animals are on passive. We're just gonna do this thing. Just go to sleep quickly and peacefully, man. It's all I want right now. He's down. He is totally down. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna get our regular arrows right here. We're gonna shoot a couple things that come near us. Now our guys are going to go back on neutral. Hopefully they don't like continue attacking this guy. Ow, my feet. Okay, so what we got to do is we are freezing right now. We got to get the narcotics on him. We're not going to put them all on there. We're going to put 25 on there for now. Let's see. Yeah, pretty much. I'm just going to be taming this guy. You've seen it before. I'm going to be trying to get prime meat if I can. If not, I'm just going to get some regular meat, which is right. Come here, both of you. Let's go. Come on, buddy. Let's do this. You coming? There we go.
I also need to make a couple campfires and I need to set myself up. But so far, right this second, we're doing okay. Looks like there's an RG right up there. Well, guess what? We got him, peeps! Look at this guy! Sorry, I might have yelled in your ear, but look at him! He's just marvelous! We have a Rex level 87! You kidding me? That is so amazing! I don't have to worry, dude. Hey, your tail is in fire, man. Oh, you don't care? You're a beast! Fire tail! I don't know. Whatever. Anyway, we do got to think of a name, but again, it's on camera, so I'm not going to be able to think of one. And, yeah, that's pretty much the thing. I just got to get him back to base. And once we do that, because it's currently ice cubing me all the time, and I'm trying, you know, it's trying to lose me health and everything, and it's not very nice. So I'm just going to chill here until it is not ice cubing me and not trying to kill me, and then we're going to go home, and I'm going to show you the things. And there he is, taking a poop. That's your first poop in the base, Rex. I may even keep his name as Rex, although I think not, just because that's the name that the game gives, and we don't want that. Anyway, so here is the Rex. You see he's all beaten up and bloody? Yeah, so was Guardian, and so was the dude I'm flying on now. They're all beat up. He just has a lot more health, so he takes longer to heal. But you see, he's getting a little bit more fed. We're going to drop some more meat into that trough right quick. I kind of organized my dinos. I'm not sure if I showed you that or not, but this one has meat in it, and there's another one over there that has all the berries and stuff in it. Anyway, so I got to stock that back up so we can heal up a lot more. But we have our Rex. He's following us, and he's amazing. Oh my goodness, look at that thing. Thing is so ferocious. So ferocious looking. He's a beast already. It's amazing. It's so amazing. Ah. He grew one level. I put health on him. And actually, let's do. Oh, stop, land thing. Good job. We're gonna do this right now. You see these stats right here. I'm gonna put an image up on the screen, showing what it was while I was taming. I have no idea if it's the same. I don't remember, but I did take a screenshot. So I figure I'm gonna chop it out and actually put it beside this. I think that would be pretty cool, just to see the comparison, just to see if there are any changes. So you should be seeing it right now. I have no idea what it's going to be, but we'll see. We'll have to check that out here in a little while. But he went all the way down to 100 health. 100 health. Why? Because he got trapped in ice. You got to watch out because there's certain parts over there in that Arctic biome where there's like little ice. I don't know how to say it, but there's like cracks in the ice. And, you know, there's space in between them sometimes. He fell down in one and got so stuck. And then Mega Piranha just came and started chomping on him. I had to go under there manually with a pike to take out the Mega Piranha to avoid him dying. I finally got him unstuck after the Mega Piranha were there. Because I didn't even know they were there at the beginning. You don't hear the music unless you're close enough to him. And I was flying way away trying to get him to follow me in random angles just to get him unstuck. But I think the Mega Piranha were actually preventing him from moving. Which is really weird, so he would have died had I not decided to fly through him to get directly to the other side, see if a sharp change would have gotten him unstuck or whatever, but doesn't matter too much. Doesn't matter because he is free, he is clear, he's healing up pretty nicely. What do you got, about 130 or health, total health? Anyway, so I put 1 point on him in health. 1 point on him. Gave him like 2,000 health or something. It was pretty ridiculous. Like, maybe not that much. Like 1,500 health. I don't know. Something. It was a huge number. It was like enormous. So this guy is going to be ridiculously hard to kill in the future. And it's going to be absolutely great because he's mine. Oh man, it's so great. Anyway, so I don't have a whole lot of time left. This is already probably being in a pretty much longer episode. But We're pretty much good. We are good. Oh, I'm sweating too, I think. I need to change back into my other armor, but that's not a big deal. I hope you guys like the episode. I really do. We got a Rex, peeps! We got a Rex! So, anyway, we're gonna make my mouth move. Ready? We got a Rex, man! I don't know why that's so cool. Anyway, so,
If you did like the episode, don't forget to hit that like button. If you want to see more and you want my videos sent directly to you, then don't forget to subscribe. Comment, favorite, share if you feel like you want to. Thanks so much for watching. Chew! Oh, excuse me. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye! Wait, can we do it? Can we do it? Oh, we just jumped my T-Rex. How cool is that?